Everyone knows what is pain, right? No, wrong. Everyone feels pain. Well, except some people who are born with a very rare genetic disorder that makes them unable to feel pain. Feeling pain does not mean that you know what pain is. It's like saying that because you feel your heart beating, then you know about the anatomy of the heart or the heart diseases. There are physicians who specialize in heart problems. They are cardiologists. I am a pain physician, a physician specialized in the pain system. Today, I will explain to you that every human being should know about that we have a pain system and to explain what this pain system is. I will show you a great resource to explain the pain system to children. Yes, I think healthy children should learn about the pain system because when they become adults, they need to understand what is going on when they feel pain, especially for those adults who will develop chronic pain. So, let's talk about the pain system today. What is this pain system? Well, it's similar to the other systems that we have in our body. We have a cardiovascular system that serves to pump blood all over the body. We have a digestive system to obtain nutrients from food, which is the fuel of our body. We have a reproductive system to allow the human species to procreate and make more human beings. We have a respiratory system that helps us to extract oxygen from the air and return carbon dioxide. So, did you know that we have a pain system? It's the alarm system of our body, similar to the alarm system that you installed in your house. You called the alarm company to come and install smoke detectors, carbon monoxide sensors, burglar, water leak, etc. This sensor sends messages to a box in the wall, and you can control the volume of the siren. You can give passwords to various people, you can turn it on or off. Then, this box on the wall communicates with a central office that will decide what to do. Do they send the police, fire truck, or ambulance to your house? And once the problem is resolved, the siren is silenced and everything goes back to normal. Well, this is what acute pain is to our body. If you have a toothache or appendicitis, the alarm will go off and tell your brain that you are in danger. You need to seek help. But there are situations where the pain alarm will not go back to silent. It will continue making noise even after the acute pain has resolved. This is what we call chronic pain. It's constant pain, daily pain for at least 3 months. It means the acute problem has resolved, but the brain continues receiving information that there is danger somewhere. And the person continues feeling pain for a long time. I recorded this video to make the case that the pain system should be taught to middle school children. Yes, you heard it right. Not only doctors and healthcare professionals need to learn about the pain system. I think all human beings need to learn about it. My children had biology classes when they were in grade 6, and they learned about the various human body systems, the cardiovascular, digestive, reproductive, respiratory, immunological, urinary, neurological, etc. But the pain system was not included in the list. Why is that? 100% of the world's population will feel some sort of pain one day or another. And 20%, which is 1 in 5 people, will end up having a disease of the pain system, which is chronic pain. We do need to include the pain system in middle school curriculum, don't you think so? If children learn about the pain system, this will prepare our next generation to understand what pain is, what chronic pain is, and how to tackle them with knowledge. They will not end up years and years trying various treatments that do not work. Treatments that work well for acute pain do not work well for chronic pain, and vice versa. You don't call the fire truck when there is a malfunction of the pain system, and you don't call the alarm company when there is a fire in the house. If you are a parent, a grandparent, a teacher, or a person with power to make decisions about school curriculum, please take a look at these resources. If you know someone who needs to see this video, hit the share button below and send this video to them. I came across this great book for children to learn about the pain system. A colleague of mine from Australia, Dr. Joshua Pate, developed and tested these materials with school children and teachers. These are great books, and they also come with activities that the kids can complete individually or in class. The first book teaches that feeling pain does not necessarily mean your body is damaged. This is a very important message that we all need to learn. We have a tendency to think, if my pain is very intense, this means I have a lot of damage or serious disease in my body. This is not true. The Green Book will teach a real story of how this belief is false. The second book teaches that anything and everything can change pain intensity. This is a very important message because for people who have chronic pain, they have good days and bad days, and sometimes they don't know why. So helping them to figure out how they can turn the volume of pain intensity down will increase the number of good days and decrease the number of bad days. The third book teaches that pain is one of the body's most powerful protectors. But in the case of chronic pain, this super protection is not helpful, and there is no more danger. Super protection will only cause people to be fearful and avoid movement. And the less they move, the worse their pain gets. The fourth book teaches that people can retrain their body and brain using an action-packed action plan. You probably have heard me talking about retraining your pain system before. I talk about this in my other video of central sensitization. And this is the first step in my book, 8 Steps to Conquer Chronic Pain. The fifth and final book teaches that having an action-packed action plan can be life-changing. It is important to keep focus on your goals. Use smarter goals to plan your actions. This is actually very similar to the 8th step in my book. So I hope I inspired you to learn more about the pain system. You can order the Zoe and Zach's Pain Hacks at your local bookstore or online. I'll put a link in the description of this video below. You can also buy my book, 8 Steps to Conquer Chronic Pain, anywhere where books are sold. And before you leave, don't forget to like this video and to write your comments below. See you next time. Bye.